Yo no sé por qué razón cantarle a ella, si debía aborrecerla con la fuerza de mi corazón. Todavía no la borro totalmente, ella siempre está presente, como ahora en esta canción. Incontables son las veces que he tratado de olvidarla y no he logrado arrancarla ni un segundo de mi mente, porque ella sabe todo mi pasado, me conoce demasiado, y es posible que por eso se aproveche, porque yo en el amor soy un idiota que ha sufrido mil derrotas, que no tengo fuerzas para entretenerle, pero ella casi siempre se aprovecha, algunas veces me desprecia y otras veces no sé para entretenerse, y es así.
chico de la calle. Camino a la ciudad con mi guitarra sin molestar a nadie. Voy cortando cadenas. Estoy luchando contra la miseria de alguna que otra pena. Pero pierdo el control. Vagando por las calles, mirando a la gente pasa, el extraño de pelo largo, sin preocupaciones va, y hay fuego en su mirada, y un poco de
hello, espero que estén muy bien. Como muchos de ustedes ya saben, hace más de un año lanzamos Académica.pe, la primera pre-online que te ayuda a preparar para ingresar a la universidad completamente gratis. Bueno, más de 135 mil alumnos ya vienen preparándose y reforzando sus estudios con nosotros y con los más de 25 cursos y sus respectivos videos teóricos y clases en vivo con profesores altamente calificados. Este domingo 26 de septiembre viene el tan esperado simulacro de medio ciclo. Y el 25 vas a poder practicar con las fijas. Así que pasa la voz, no pierdas esta oportunidad. Regístrate gratis en académica.pe. Ay, me olvidaba. Para todos los que participen, habrá un sorteo con grandes premios. Porque en Académica, tu aprendizaje es nuestra misión.
Se disfrazan de intuición y en una voz tuya.
se esconde. Y en una voz tu voz se esconde. Siga viendo tu cara en la cara de la luna, mientras siga escuchando tu voz entre las horas, entre la espuma. Mientras tenga que cambiar la radio de estación, porque cada canción me hable de ti, de ti, de ti.
Recording in progress.
Hello, everybody. Good afternoon. Good afternoon, María, José. Good afternoon, Joshua. ¿Cómo están, chicos? ¿Qué tal el fin de semana? Good afternoon, Fabiola. Good afternoon, guys. ¿Cómo está su fin de semana? Sí, hoy día hay sol. ¿Por su zona también hay sol? Qué bueno. Han aprovechado de lavar la ropa. Me parece muy bien, me parece muy bien. Very good. Qué bueno, qué bueno. Sí, hay que aprovechar el sol ahí. Una vuelta en el parque para que les dé los rayos solares. Vitaminas ahí, al cuerpo. Yes. Good afternoon, Daphne, Xiomara. Y así, Nini, good afternoon. ¿Qué? Acá me mandan como esperancito cuando hay sol. Bueno, yo ya que aprovechar el sol. Aprovechar el sol. No sé si han visto ese meme que dicen que cuando hay sol, cuando tienes 20 años o menos, ya es este símbolo de juerga, ¿no? Pero cuando tienes de 30 años a más, es símbolo de lavar la ropa, que va a secar, pues. Entonces, ya después ya te va a gustar cuando haya sol, vas a ver. Okay. Okay, guys. Today, what are you going to do today? El día de hoy vamos a hacer preposition. Okay, I bother my dog. Okay, you're so... Sí, es bueno sacar a los que tienen mascotitas. Es bueno sacarlos a pasear con ese solcito. Okay, so today we are going to talk about preposition in, on, and at, then action verbs, and finally verb to be. Okay. Pero antes, ¿dejamos tarea de la clase pasada? A ver, hágame recordar, por favor. ¿Qué me hace recordar? ¿Sí, Wo? Sí, dejé tarea, ¿no? Let's see. ¿Cuándo fue nuestra última clase? Lunes, ¿no? Yes, fue lunes. ¿Qué? A ver, ese mensaje no lo leí. Buenas tardes, quisiera saber cuándo acabo de decir. Ah, no, sí lo leí, sí lo respondí este mensaje. Ya. A ver, vamos a ver. El día lunes fue la última tarea, ¿no? De básico. 13, entonces. Vamos al 13. 13. Acá está. 13. Ok. ¿Qué teníamos que hacer? Possessive pronouns. ¿Verdad? ¿Quién lo hizo? A ver. ¿Quién lo hizo? Para revisar. Para revisar y todos ayudemos juntos. ¿Quién hizo la clase? A ver, chicos. Xiomara, ¿tú lo has hecho? ¿Y a dónde estás tú? New start on Tuesday. Okay, welcome, Fabiola. Welcome to the class. Carla, ya, Mirele. Xiomara, ¿dónde estás? Mira, Ángel, acá está, ya te vi. Ya. Okay, recuerden. A ver, ay, ¿qué hice? Recuerden que ya está publicada. Recuerdo, ya está publicado las clases, ¿verdad? O sea, ¿qué es lo que va a venir en cada clase? Publicamos la clase pasada. Ahora no se acuerdan. ¿Eso no? Ajá, ya lo voy a poner acá, a ver. Sí, aquí está, justo en la comunidad lo puse. Ahí está, schedule. September. A ver, para los que son nuevos, aquí está el calendario. Este es de septiembre, de este mes, que acaba la otra semana. Ok. So, today we are in session 12. Tomorrow is session 39. Then, session 30. And on Thursday, we have a listening class tips. Ok. Yeah, this is a special class. And on Friday, you know, we have songs. Okay? Are you ready? Okay, very good. Comencemos. So I need a volunteer who wants to read, please. Number one, number two, number three, and all of them. Please, I need a volunteers. Come on, volunteers. Okay, Maria Jose, number one, please.
Yes, good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon.
We bought that house last year. It is ours.
Yes, very good. Thank you. Okay, number two, Fabiola, please.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon.
This car,
good afternoon.
This car belongs to Mr. Smith. It is theirs.
Theirs, perfect. Thank you. Next. Number three, Xiomara, please.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon.
I think I saw John drop this pen. I think it is this his.
Yes, very good. Thank you. Number four, Ermelinda, please.
The book is mine. It has my name on it.
On it, perfect. Thank you. Very good. And number five, Yamili, please. Yamili.
Good afternoon, teacher.
Good afternoon.
My brother and I made the share is all. All
is our. Perfect. Very good. Number six. Number six, Cielo, please.
Excuse me, this phone is yours. You forget to take it with you.
Very good. You forgot, no? You forgot to take it with you. Very good. Next, number seven. Who want to participate, number seven? Vamos, chicos. La única forma de practicar es aquí en clase. Come on. Anímense los demás. Ok. Number seven, please, María José.
Her sister drew the picture. It's hers.
It's hers. Very good. Number eight, Xiomara, please.
The little boy shouted, give the ball to me. It's mine.
It's mine. Very good. Thank you. Next, number nine, Ermelinda, please. Hermelinda.
Night. Does ours he bought is last night at the department store?
Very good. Department store. Not it's ours. Very good. Next, Yamili, please. Number 10.
The bicycle were there, so they rode then home after school.
After school, very good. Next, number 11, Daphne.
Are you sure this book belongs to your mother?
Yes, it's hers.
It's hers, very good. Okay. We're continuing. Okay, a ver. Hello, Obed. Hello, Fanny. Hello, Diana. Good afternoon, chicos. Next, number 12. Cielo, please.
Good afternoon, miss.
Good afternoon. Number 12,
this is yours. You ordered the pizza. I ordered the spaghetti.
Okay, thank you. Yes, this is yours. Huh? You ordered the pizza and I ordered the spaghetti. Very good. Number 13, Maria Jose, please.
Is this Robert's? No, it's not his.
No, it's not his. Very good. Number 14, Xiomara, please.
I think these keys are mine. I left them on the table.
Okay, very good. Thank you. And the last one, number 15, Hermelinda. Hermelinda.
Thomas can find his classroom, but Susan and Mary can find theirs.
Very good. Good. Perfect. Okay. So let's continue with our class for today. Here. There you are. Okay. Good afternoon, Carla. Next. I miss one. Que me salte uno. ¿Cuál? Oh, welcome, Carla. Welcome. ¿Cuál me salte? Good afternoon, Jesua. Ninguno. Pensé que me había salteado uno. Okay, thank you. Continue, so we are continuing. Okay, so we are going to do is a listening part. Remember, recuerden que vamos a escuchar dos veces el audio, ¿de acuerdo? Y de ahí vamos a contestar las preguntas. Yes, are you ready? Ready, ready, ready. Okay, a ver, vamos a empezar. A ver, un ratitín. Vamos a poner acá el audio. Ya está, creo que sí. Porque siempre me fallan los audios. No lo sé. Ya, ahora sí. Me avisan si no escuchan, ¿eh?
Wait. Hello.
Hello, Roger. This is Ann.
Oh, hi, Ann. How have you been? And how's your new apartment working out?
Well, that's what I'm calling about. You see, I've decided to look for a new place.
Oh, what's the problem with your place now? I thought you liked the apartment.
Oh, I do, but it's a little far from campus, and the commute is just killing me. Do you think you could help? I thought you might know more about the housing situation at the school.
Okay, what's your budget like? I mean, how much do you want to spend on rent?
Somewhere under $200 a month, including utilities, if I could. Oh, and I prefer to rent a furnished apartment.
And anything else?
Yeah, I need a parking space.
Well, I know there's an apartment complex around the corner that seems to have a few vacancies. I'll drop by there on my way to class today.
Hey, thanks a lot.
No problem. Hello?
Hello, Roger. This is Anne.
Oh, hi, Anne. How have you been? And how's your new apartment working out?
Well, that's what I'm calling about. You see, I've decided to look for a new place.
Oh, what's the problem with your place now? I thought you liked the apartment.
Oh, I do, but it's a little far from campus, and the commute is just killing me. Do you think you could help? I thought you might know more about the housing situation at the school.
Okay, what's your budget like? I mean, how much do you want to spend on rent?
Somewhere under $200 a month, including utilities, if I could. Oh, and I prefer to rent a furnished apartment.
And anything else?
Yeah, I need a parking space.
Well, I know there's an apartment complex around the corner that seems to have a few vacancies. I'll drop by there on my way to class today.
Hey, thanks a lot.
No problem.
Okay, let's see. Question number one. What is the main topic of the conversation? Has shares of a new apartment, the problem with the living in the apartment, the cost of the rents near universities? So what is my answer in question number one? Yes, a search for a new apartment. Yes, very good. Number two. Why doesn't Anne like her current apartment? Why? Why she wants to move? It is far from the campus. The neighborhood is noisy. It's too expensive. What do you think it is? Yes, it's far from the campus. Letter A, very good. Next, number three. How much money does Anne want to pay for rent? A, no more than £200. B, a little more than £200. Or C, around £200. What do you think it is? My answer. Number three, letter A, no more than £200. ¿Qué es lo que dice ahí en esa pregunta, la tres? ¿Cuánto le va a costar? ¿O cuánto quiere pagar por la renta, Ana? ¿Verdad? A ver, vamos a escuchar el audio, porque aquí la mayoría ha fallado. Vamos a ver. Vamos a escuchar nuevamente.
Hello.
Hello, Roger. This is Anne.
Oh, hi, Anne. How have you been? And how's your new apartment working out?
Well, that's what I'm calling about. You see, I've decided to look for a new place.
Oh, what's the problem with your place now? I thought you liked the apartment.
Oh, I do, but it's a little far from campus, and the commute is just killing me. Do you think you could help? I thought you might know more about the housing situation at the school.
Okay, what's your budget like? I mean, how much do you want to spend on rent?
Somewhere under $200 a month, including utilities, if I could. Oh, and I prefer to rent a furnished apartment.
Okay, so it's no more than 200. So su límite de ella es 200 pounds. ¿Sí? Entonces, ni más de 200 quiere, o alrededor de 200, no, 200 es lo máximo que puede pagar ella. So it's letter A, okay? Next, number four. Anne wants to rent an apartment that is close to campus in a good neighborhood. Already has a furniture. What is my answer? Number four. What is my answer? Number four. Yes, letter C. Already has a furniture. Eso lo dice en la última parte. Me vamos a escuchar otra vez.
To your place now. I thought you liked the apartment.
Oh, I do, but it's a little far from campus and the commute is just killing me. Do you think you could help? I thought you might know more about the housing situation at the school.
Okay, what's your budget like? I mean, how much do you want to spend on rent?
Somewhere under $200 a month, including utilities, if I could.
Including the utilities, if I could. ¿Qué quiere decir? que se incluyan todos los implementos o todo lo que se tiene en un apartamento. Yes, okay. And number five, to help Roger is going to, where is he going to? Yes, check out an apartment. Yes, he going to check out for a new apartment for her friend. Okay, very good. Next. Okay, today what are you going to do? We are going to talk about Charlie Chaplin. Sorry. No, vamos a conocer la historia de Charlie Chaplin. Okay, so I need a volunteer to read, please. From here to here and here. Here to to here. Yes, and here. Bueno, voy a leer un poquito más. From here to here. Okay, and then here. Sorry. Okay. O lo partimos mejor. Here, y lo vamos a partir, ¿ya? Here. Para que no lean mucho. Ahí está. Y den opciones que otros participen. From here to here. And the last part. Okay, so I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. I need 11 volunteers, please. Okay, let's start. Please, María José, start.
Charlie Chaplin's early life. He was believed to have been born on April 16, 1889. There is some doubt whether April 16 is actually his birthday, and it is possible he was not born in 1889. There is also uncertainty about his birthplace, London or Fontainebleau, France.
Okay, thank you. Very good. ¿Cómo se dice los años? Es 1889. Los años se dividen en dos y se pronuncia el primero, 1889. A partir del 2000, que es por ejemplo este año en que estamos, 2021, acá se dice todo junto, 2021. Okay, pero a partir del 1999 hacia abajo se partía en dos. Por ejemplo, 1999, 1999. Ok, esa es la diferencia. Lo otro es tough weather, April 16 is actually his birthday. Ok, very good, Maria. Next, Xiomara, please.
Not tough, who, however, as to his parentage. He was born to Charles Chaplin, Sr. and Hannah Harriet Hill, a Calili Harley on stage, but music hall entertainers. His parents separated soon after his birth, leaving him in the care of his increasingly unstable mother.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay. Parentage, ¿qué significa parentesco? Parentage, Sears and Hannah, ¿no? Chaplin, Sears. Y el otro es separate, separate. Okay, very good. Good afternoon, Janet. Next, Ermelinda, please.
Yeah. In 1896, Chaplin's mother has enabled to find work. Charlie and his older half brother Sidney Chaplin had to be left in the workhouse and Lambeth, moving after several weeks to humble schools for orphans and study children.
Okay, very good. Thank you. Next, Fabiola, please continue.
Okay, his father died an alcoholic when Charlie was 12, and his mother suffered a mental breakdown and was eventually admitted temporarily to the Kane Hill Asylum at Coldstone near Croydon.
Okay, very good. Thank you. And next, Cielo, please. Ah, no, creo que ya te... Cielo? No. Sí, ¿no? Ok, creo que me confundí. Ya mi Cielo, ¿te toca o ya te tocó? ¿Cómo es? Ah, no, ya me confundí, sorry. Okay, Yamili, please.
She did in 1928 and United States 2 years after coming to the state to live with Chaplin by 10, a commercial success.
Okay, very good, no? She died, commercial success. Okay, very good. Next, Maria Jose, please.
Charlie first took to the stage when age 5. He performed in music hall in 1894, stating in for his mother. As a child, he was confined to a bed for weeks due to serious illness, and at night, his mother would sit at the window and ask out what was going on outside.
Okay, thank you. Very good. Xiomara, continue.
In 1908, 11, his brother helped get him the role of the comic cat in the pantomime Cinderella at the London Hippodrome. In 1903, he appeared in him a romance of cocaine, followed by his first regular job as the newspaper boy Billy in Sherlock Holmes, a part he played into 1906.
Okay, thank you. Next, Carmelina, continue, please.
According to immigration records, he arrived at the United States with the Colonel Troop on October 2, 1912. In the Colonel Company was Arthur Stanley Jefferson, who would later become known as Stan Laurel. Chaplin and Laurel shared a room in a boarding house.
Okay, thank you. Creo que nos hemos saltado un párrafo. Dice, this was a folly but cancels core circle. Okay, the last part, please. Cielo. The last part. Cielo. No, Cielo. Okay. No creo. Fabiola, please, the last part.
Stan Laurel returned to England, but Chaplin remained in the United States. Chaplin's ad was seen by film producer Mack Sennett, who hired him for his studio, Pakistan Film Company.
Okay, thank you. Okay, we'll continue. Good afternoon, Esteban. Good afternoon, Italo. Why you're coming late, Italo? Okay, question number one. Chaplin might have been born some years early than current belief. True or false? What do you think it is? In the same year, the Coraline? Is true or false? False? True, yes, Yamari, is true. No, Chambly has been born some years early, the current belief, yes. ¿Qué año nació? Yes, él nació. ¿En qué año nació él exactamente? Exactly. 1889. Ajá. Y nació casi por ahí. Yes, so it's true. True. Number two. Champlin's mother died before her son was successful. It's true or false? What about the mother's Champlin? False, yes. She died when she died. Champlin wasn't able to find work. So where's Housewife movie? False, yes, in 1928, no? She died before, yes, false. Number three, Champlin's first performance on the stage after arriving in the United States. It's true or false? She died in the United States 2 years after coming to stay with a Chaplin but commercial success. What do you think is number three? False. Yes, it's false. Good. No, what was his first performance? No, Charlie first took the stage when age five. He performed a music hall in 1995. 1894, standing in the his mother. Yes, very good. Next, number four. His first serious job was a delivery newspaper. It's true or false, number four? Charlie fix to stay when he's five in perform music hall. False, yes, number four is false. Su primer trabajo formal no era como, no era de newspaper, no era de repartidor de periódico. Yes. Number five, his first partner on the stage was the actor Stan Lauren. It's true or false? What do you think it is? And number five. False, yes, false. ¿Quién era su primer compañero? Entonces, ¿quién era? ¿Cuál fue entonces su primer compañero, su primer partner? Let's see. The hell, children, months of following his first regular newspaper, Bill Osborne. He was Fred Cornos, Company. And Fred Cornos in a Kung Company stick. According to the record, he received United States with Cornos Trove on October. Cornos, who later became known as Stanley Chaplin. Share a room. No, después se volvió su amigo, ¿verdad? Pero él estaba solo. Okay, good. And the last one. He was discovered while working a British organization in the United States. Yes, no. True or false? What do you think it is? Sí, su partner era su padre. Yes, Yomara, thank you. False, yes. False? Su primer discover while working fue descubierto cuando estaba trabajando en ¿dónde? En la Organización Británica de Estados Unidos. A ver. According to the company. Yes, it's true. Oh, no. Yeah, I think it's true. Que retornó a England. Yeah, he was covered by Mark's Senate. Ajá. Y estaba justo en ese escenario, ¿verdad? Yes, it's true, entonces. So, okay, it's true. Okay. Very good. Good. So, we'll continue. Okay, we have to put here a preposition. Okay, just let me know where is the answer. No? For example, number one, my brother has a new job. He's work in the evening. Number two, we are going to have a picnic Saturday afternoon. Would you like to come? On, yes, on Saturday afternoon. Okay, very good. Number three, I will finish my work an hour, then I can go home. What do you think is my answer? In an hour, at an hour, yes, no, recuerden que el at siempre va a ser para temas de horas, yes, okay. Number four, when is the meeting? It is what? It is at 2, yes, very good, at 2. Number five, I like to get up really early. Sunrise, when the birds start singing. When the birds start sing. On, yes, on sunrise. Cuando estaba con los rayos del sol, yes. Tom's birthday is next week, January 14. ¿Qué podría ser ahí? On, yes, on. Si bien es cierto, los meses del año es in, pero cuando a ese mes del año le pongo un día específico, allá cambia, ¿sí? Porque ya estamos hablando de una fecha. Entonces, en esos casos de fecha, ya ahí que vendría a ser algo específico. Por eso estamos usando, ¿qué cosa? On. Yes, on. Okay. ¿Quedó claro? Okay. Continue. My grandfather was born in the 1950. In the 1950. ¿Qué voy a poner ahí? A ver. In, yes. Cuando hablamos de años, siempre vamos a poner in. Okay. Continue. Will we be time or will we miss our flight? ¿Qué vamos a poner ahí como respuesta? A ver, ¿qué vamos a poner, chicos? On. On time, yes, ¿no? Para que llegue a tiempo. No estamos dando un tiempo específico, simplemente estamos diciendo que llegue a tiempo. Por eso acá es on. Very good. Next, number 9. My family and I like to ski winter. ¿Qué voy a poner ahí? Okay, ¿qué voy a poner ahí? In winter, yes, very good. In winter. Next, are there any holidays October? ¿Qué voy a poner ahí? ¿Qué voy a poner ahí? In October. Yes, very good. In October. Number 11. Our school cafeteria open for lunch noon. ¿Qué voy a poner ahí? At number 11, at, yes, very good, at. Okay, and then number 3, creo que hay una confusión, dice, I will finish my work en una hora, no estamos diciendo en una hora específica, sino en que en una hora acabo, como decir. Entonces, cuando hablamos, cuando hacemos mención a de que es en una hora, no en una hora determinada, sino que me va a tomar una hora de tiempo de poder hacerlo. Entonces, ¿qué podría ir ahí? ¿Cuál podría ser mi respuesta? In, yes, very good. In an hour. No voy a acabar en una hora, más o menos. Yes. Yes, en el caso de number 5, creo que también hay una confusión. Dice, I like to get up early. Sunrise es como que amaneciendo. Ah, entonces cuando hablamos de tiempo, ahí se diría at. No, o sea, de todo mi día en algo específico, el amanecer. Ajá. Entonces acá sería at. Ok. Y lo demás creo que lo veo bien. Ok, continue. Number 12. What time does your son go to bed? At, yes, at night. No existe in the night, mucho menos on the night. Siempre va a ser at night. Ok, yeah, siempre va a ser at night, chicos. Ok. Teacher number 10. A ver, Fabiola. Number 10, yes. Cuando hablamos de los meses del año, es in January, in February, in March, in April, in June, in July. Siempre va a ser in. Yes, ok. Continue. Number 13, we move out to this city, cuando hablamos de los días del año, in, yes, very good, in, no, in, okay, very good. Next, number 14, are you going to do anything special? Special what? On, yes, on your birthday, ¿no? Cuando hablamos de eventos específicos, el cual también incluye tu cumpleaños, es on. Very good. Number 15, I'm going to watch that show, it starts midnight. At, yes, it starts at midnight. Yes, very good, at. Okay, very good. Ok, Okay, next, we'll continue. Dice, tenemos que poner qué cosa, la S o la ES dependiendo, exacto, dependiendo de si es plural, ¿no? ¿Cómo se escribe? O algunos ES, otros S. Ok, number one es watches. Ok, number two, Mr. Smith goes. Yes, goes. Number three, Susan studies. No, es study number three, chicos. Es studies. Studies, exacto. Studies. Number four, bring an umbrella with me and eat. It what? It rain nada más, ajá. Rains con S, very good. Next, number five, young in a small apartment downtown. Live, very good, live. Next, number six. It's an hour for me to go to work in the mornings. Takes, yeah. Takes, very good. Number seven. My husband, all cars in the free time. It is hobby. Number seven. Fixes, yes, very good, fixes. Next, my cat, number eight. My cat sleeps, muy bien, sleeps. Okay, continue, number nine, Stuart. Too much about his job. He should relax more. Worries. Yes, very good. Worries. Very good. Next, continue. Number 11, no, number 10. My classmate always her homework on time. Okay, number 10, my classmate always go, does, yes, very good, does. Next, number 11, my little brother cries, yes, very good, cries. Number 12, Jennifer Harris. Yes, very good. Harris. Number 12, Harris. Very good. Very good. Okay, Harris. Number 13, Mr. Johnson sometimes what? Plays, yes, very good, plays. Number 14, watches, very good, watches. Next, number 15, Sue moved to a new city in May. How she what? Number 15, Mrs. Very good, Mrs. Number 16, my father drive. Yes, very good, drive. Drive. Okay. Very good. Ok, vamos, terminemos esto para dejar otra tarea nada más. Vamos. Number two, así rapidito. Antes que nos van a la hora, si no esto va a quedar de tarea. Number two, ¿cuál sería mi respuesta? Think, muy bien, very good. Tenemos que señalar lo que es, lo que son verbos nada más. Think, very good. Number three. Talk, very good. Number four, visit, very good. Number five, okay, number six, smile, yes, very good. Number seven, cook, very good. Isn't it cook, it says clock. Ah, cook, de arriba, okay, sorry. Number eight, listen, very good. Number nine, search, very good. Number 10, a ver, chicos, number 10, kicken, ese es patear, kick. Number 11, climb, very good. Number 12, honk, muy bien, cazar. Number 13, discover, yes, very good. And last one, number 14. Sell, yes, very good. Okay. Y esto de acá es for homework, que es el verbo to be, ponerlo tanto en positivo y en negativo de acuerdo a mi o a mi texto, ¿ok? Muy bien, esto va a ser de homework. Ahorita lo voy a subir para que lo hagan, ¿ok, guys? Va a estar bastante sencilla tarea. Okay, guys, that's all for today. Thank you for being in the class. Please take care. Have a nice week. Bye-bye.